The bhajan singers don't need to do any sadhana. You don't need to do any sadhana. After great sadhana, you have become bhajan singers. That too, bhajan singers in Satya Sai at the lotus feet of Swami. You don't need to sing. You don't need to do any more sadhana, because the only sadhana God has given you to sing bhajans and give joys to millions and millions and millions of people. That is the sadhana you are doing. You are already crossed all other sadhanas, and this is now you are sharing this beautiful love of God with millions of people across. I'll tell you one secret. Why Swami emphasized so much on bhajans, so much of it. You know how long a human being lives? Generally how much? We'll say 100 years. But it is not true. The time and calendar is created by human beings. It's not created by God. It seems every human being is given his lifespan not by the years, but by breath. So many breaths you will breathe on this planet. So many breaths you will have. After that many breaths to finish, you may take 60 years, you may take 80 years, you may take 96 years, you may take 108 years. But you are given a quantity of breaths. And believe me, how wonderful being a bhajan singer. So many breaths you are using for God. None of us use so much of breaths for God. And you are able to use that breath for God. So much of your life is getting sanctified. So much of your life is sanctified. And Satya Sai Bhajan movement, this movement, I must say, when my brothers consent, that it is taken forward mostly very strongly by only Mahila groups, and we must put our hands together for that. It's Mahila groups which have carried this bhajan movements or whatever to do with this kind of the finer aspects of bhajans. It's the Mahilas who have carried. Because I'll tell you one, I must recollect that there is one lady in Prashanti Nilayam for good 45-50 years, every day morning sings Suprabhatam. Even now, it is not a gents, it's a lady who has been able to do for 50 consecutive years without leaving Prashanti Nilayam. I think you must have known that, you know, Ushaji is there. It's just is a representation of your community, your sisters, that I'm saying that such a wonderful commitment has happened from the ladies' side to the Sai movement, and we should be always grateful to the sisters who have taken forward. Many a times Nagar Sankirtan has started by ladies, bhajan groups, even Bombay, we have heard lot of all the bhajan groups and Nagar Sankirtan started by lady devotees, most of the places. So keep this saga of wonderful bhajans. We are all blessed to have Sai bhajans. And Sai bhajan is the easy to connect. And Swami has said, when you do bhajan, clap and do it. Because he said, when you go under a tree and clap, all the crows and all the everything will fly away. The birds which are disturbing, which are dirtying the place, they all run away. When you go under a tree and clap. That's how, when you clap and do bhajan, Swami has said, all the unwanted thoughts will fly away and you have space for the good things to occupy. So always participate in bhajan in ecstasy. Swami, you know, you see in Swami singing, how much when he sings, the kind of, I do not know what is the exact word in English, but I say that ardhrata, say the kind of that deep feeling with which Swami sings the bhajan, being himself an avatar, whenever you hear him so much and so loudly, so he is in ecstasy, he just forgets himself and sings these bhajans, so wonderful. Imagine 1 hour, 2 hours, Swami has conducted bhajans himself all the way. I have a cassette, 45 minutes he continuously sings, and he's singing in a, with so much of enthu, so much of joy, and wonderful it is, just wonderful. So he has this moment, I think it's the only panacea for us. Please take these bhajans. I'm sure Swami will bless all of you, not only 50 years, yes. 50 years of not here bhajan group, what are we celebrating? The 50 years we had this opportunity. Let us celebrate this blessing. Not the age of the group, but because people are already moved on, some people may not be there, but this saga of love between Swami and between us will continue. Keep this wonderful, wonderful bhajans going on forever and ever. You are giving joy to everybody. Please continue to give us joy. And before close, I will tell you one small thing. Swami was very fond of bhajans. What I have observed is, he would not close any day. As far as whenever I had the chance to see last 30, 40 years, as a kid, then later on coming to that, he would not close any day. I observed him doing this many times, even if it's a night, 8 o'clock, where he reaches some place and there is some group, he'll say, okay, one bhajan chalu. And if there is a bhajan is not planned, he would say, bhajan chayindi, like that, he would say bhajan. He's always insisted, his day never closed without bhajan. Not for himself, but for us. So always, don't neglect any bhajan session. Not for singers, I'm telling for my own brothers and others who are sisters, who are not bhajan singers, but we can come and take this, because that's one place. Mad bhakta, yatra gayanti, tatra tishtami. Definitely in bhajan session, Swami will be present. You'll be very assured. So we can come and take his love and just be lost in him. Be lost in him. Thank you very much. And again, Dhaka Point team, and all the bhajan groups all over the country, they are participating here. Please spread this love. Please spread this Sai message through bhajans. And may Swami bless all of you with wonderful voice, wonderful opportunity to sing in his presence. And may Swami bless each one of you on this golden jubilee. And may the Sai bhajans will be sung on this planet forever and ever. Sai Ram.